Hello and welcome to the Automotive Diagnosis YouTube channel. This video shows you the testing procedure for P0076 and P0077 engine fault codes, which are for the intake VVT solenoid valve. Please stay with us until the end of the video and support us by sharing the video and subscribing the channel. As these fault codes are for the intake VVT solenoid, or OCV, I will start by talking about the relevant wiring diagram. Then I check the power supply on the OCV. Next step is to check the OCV itself. Then we will see the procedure to test the OCV control line. Next is the short-to-power testing procedure for P0077. And finally, we will have a look at the OCV waveforms at different engine conditions. Let's start by wiring diagram analysis. Let's see the main components first. This is engine control module. This one is oil control valve or OCV. And this is engine main relay. As soon as you turn the ignition switch on, ECM will energize the main relay, so battery positive will be provided on the OCV. And when engine is running, ECM manages the OCV operation via the control line. So, the checkpoints for this fault codes are as follows. OCV power supply circuit. OCV control line. And OCV itself. The correct procedure to test the OCV battery positive voltage. As I said before, as soon as you turn the ignition switch on, OCV will receive the battery positive voltage from the engine main relay. So for testing the voltage, remove the intake OCV connector, turn the ignition switch on, then measure the voltage between power terminal of OCV harness connector and chassis ground. Make sure you read the battery voltage in this test. I got the battery voltage, meaning that power supply is okay. So I am going to test the OCV. Testing procedure of the intake CVVT solenoid valve. You can test the OCV, even without removing it, if you have a scan tool. So use the actuation test, and activate the intake OCV, when engine is running. If engine hesitates, it means that the OCV is functioning. If you don't have the scan tool, you can perform the same test manually. Disconnect the intake OCV connector, then start the engine. Apply the battery positive and negative on the OCV as shown here. If engine hesitates or stalls, it means that OCV is working. Otherwise, you have to remove the OCV to test it thoroughly. If you have removed the OCV, you can perform another actuation test to make sure it's working. So apply the battery positive and negative and check the OCV operation sound and check the spool valve movement. If you don't see any sign of function, you must replace the OCV. Test the OCV internal resistance using a multimeter. Make sure the resistance is same as the specifications in the workshop manual. As you see, the resistance value in this case is more than 7.5 ohm. If you don't get any measurement or it is too high, you must replace the OCV. If OCV is okay, we need to test the control line. For testing the OCV control line, we can start by checking the short to ground. So, while OCV connector is disconnected, use a multimeter and check the continuity between the OCV harness connector and the chassis ground. In this test, you should not have the continuity, otherwise, control line is shorted to the ground, which needs to be found and to be fixed. No reading in this case means there is not continuity, showing that control line is not shorted. Now we can check the control line continuity between the OCV harness connector and ECM harness connector. So, disconnect the ECM connectors, locate the intake OCV control line pin, then use a multimeter and check the continuity between OCV and ECM. You must have the continuity in this case, otherwise you got the open circuit, which causes the OCV malfunction. If your fault code is P0077, it means the voltage on the control line is too high. So there is another step that you must perform, which is checking the short to power on the control line. So, you can check the continuity between the control line and the power supply while ignition switch is off. This test should not get any continuity. If so, it means that the power supply and control line are shorted to each other, which must be fixed. No continuity sounds means these two wires are not shorted to each other. Another way to test the short to power is to check the voltage on the control line. If you measure the high voltage like the battery voltage, it means the control line is shorted to the positive voltage. And the last section is the OCV waveforms. Here we provided two waveforms of the OCV operation when engine is on idle and at acceleration. You can get the OCV waveform by an oscilloscope and compare it with the specification. I hope you enjoyed the video. If so, please keep supporting us by sharing the video and subscribing the channel.